Hey and welcome to a new game. Okay, we're gonna play another one. I think we go back to standard. Large map is a little bit much, maybe. I am thinking about keeping the no tech trading though. Let's play another game with no tech trading, but let's allow versus states this time, I think. No huts, no events, no tech trading. Last time we did a fractal map, sure. I think that's fine, really. Maybe shuffle. Let's do shuffle. It's similar, but I don't even know the difference, really, but I know I've played many fractal games and shuffle not so much. Let's go with that and maybe random climate. Shuffle, random climate. Make sure I keep it's all right. I think it's okay. Yeah. Let's go random, I think. See what we get. Monty, okay. Monty, yeah, it's not a great leader. Spiritual is good. Especially in a long game, yeah, you have no tech trading, so you have to maximize your own economy. That can be really nice, spiritual. Aggressive, yeah, also not bad, but for an early rush. I mean, it's good, you know, if you for a construction rush, you have no elephants. It makes a big difference, you know, getting combat 2 spearmen or shock X-Men. Of course, the starting techs are pretty underwhelming. Yeah, it's pretty bad. We might be inland. Sure, should be okay, but if you have like a coastal start, maybe with a lot of forest, I mean, what do you do? You need fishing, you need bronze working, you need all kinds of crap. Then, unique unit, Jaguar. It's a weaker swordsman, but he doesn't require any metal, so I suppose if you go for a construction rush, you have no metal, you can build these, but not really, you know, woodsman 1, yeah, you have woodsman 1 promotion, okay, but I'm really not a big fan of that unit. And then you have, okay, that's pretty good, sacrificial altar, courthouse, that's cheaper than a regular courthouse, and minus 50% anger duration, yeah, so you can whip a lot more and get less unhappiness from that. That's pretty good, especially in a game with no tech trading. Building courthouses is very much a viable idea. I mean, it's okay. Yeah, okay. So that's what we have here. Before I continue, let me check really quickly if I'm recording. Yeah, looking good. Okay, looking good. And yeah, let's check. Fairly big map, more than 1,000 land tiles. 6 enemies, of course. Rocky climate. Oh, so actually in a rocky climate, we are fortunate to have floodplains, so we are in a rich area, probably. Actually, the capital is pretty good. You have marble as well, maybe go for some wonders there. Great library comes to mind. And Hammurabi is in the game, but not Mianzi Musa. Because a bowman counts for a bit more, like I think standard is 26,000 soldiers because of the archers, and then you get a few points for like mining and stuff like that. But 28,000 only Hammurabi has that because of the bowman. Mianzi Musa has 30,000, so he's not in the game, obviously. So we have checked the stuff, and yeah, I'm pretty happy here. I mean, I don't see a big reason to move. The plane's still here, but I have no idea what's here. I mean, I might be moving into the jungle for all I know. The scout is also not in a position to really help me out here. So I think I'm just gonna, I don't know, like, yeah, I mean, you could. Yeah, I do wonder actually, because you could, theoretically, you could go here. It's fresh water, it would get more floodplains, I would lose a marble. I don't like this idea very much though, because I'm moving towards the north, it's a tundra here. Right now I'm in a fairly good position, I'm gonna block off this area, keep, and this can be backfilled. So I wouldn't really voluntarily move here, it's just to get a sheep. I mean, a sheep and floodplains, yeah, right? I mean, here would be five floodplains, here I have like, I have three here as well though, and this would also lead to more unhealthiness, and like I said, the marble is good. It's a nice capital, I mean, don't think you can, oh my god, yeah, and that's even better, of course, I mean, holy crap. Huh, okay, so we are going agriculture for sure, let's wait a few turns, maybe we meet somebody. If you know somebody that knows the tech, you get a little discount. So we are counting on that. Now, in all my games recently, I always had Montezuma as an enemy, from what I can remember. So this time, no Monty, at least, since we are Monty. Okay, with all the tundra here, I would maybe check for fish here. Because if there is no fish here, I would probably go here, actually. Since I can share that, it has fresh water from the oasis. And this guy can use of all the corn, and there is no early happiness thing that I can, from what I can tell. No early gold or anything. And I'm not charismatic. So I'm gonna be limited in the amount of things I can work, and corn and floodplains is more than enough in the early game. And this can be shared and claim more floodplains, and then you also have this place, so I don't know, maybe we want to go there. I like the start though, it's nice, it's good. This area here is a bit worrying me a little bit, there's some huge area that probably I have to defend, since I don't think anybody's gonna be up there. Might go for archery, really. I mean, yeah, we are aggressive, but what the hell, man, who is that? Looks like Pekel, maybe. Looks like some guy who is taking my land. Okay, so he can deal with this crap here. He can deal with all of them. But oh, Cyrus, okay, Persian. Interesting. Maybe I'm thinking early destruction. I'm thinking early destruction might be on the cards here. Yeah, I mean, Monty, not the worst ex-Russian, but ideally I would like to have some gold. I will get the oasis, that's good. Bit more commerce out of that. Let's pick agriculture. Does he know anybody? Don't think he knows anybody. What if he and I might be alone on this continent? I mean, it's possible. Okay, so that's the second city. It's on flatland from what I can tell. I think I should check out. I also want to check out the river here, really, but maybe I can take a peek in here. I can take a peek from the other side, I think. This looks like it's forested. I won't really see much anyway. So let's go there, and I'm pretty sure like where I want to go is like here, and it's a bit passive actually. It's a bit passive because he's gonna claim all that other land here, and now you might think, just go like, it's good land here actually. It's good land, but it's also gonna be very hard to defend in the early game because of all the barbarians. It's flat land, you know, and I'm not gonna get this up for a long time, the camp here. I would need archers, or even, like, there could, yeah, man, it's gonna be really problematic. On the other hand, here you have, you know, the cow here can be claimed. It's three tiles away from my capital, and then I can just take that from him. He can develop, he can kill the barbarians, he can develop the land here, and then I just go in and bam, and that's it. Maybe with X-Men, but I'm thinking, you know, maybe horse archers, because I do have an excuse to go for early animal husbandry. I have decent commerce, not the best, but definitely decent. And, or maybe just wait for construction. It's also gonna depend a little bit on the situation, like who else do we have here. There's no tech trading though, so it doesn't really matter. But of course, if there's lots of land that I can get peacefully, then maybe we can, you know, coexist a bit for a little bit peacefully. It's Cyrus though, he can be aggressive, but you get him too pleased and he won't attack you ever. Yeah, so many things to think about here. Too early to make an informed decision. Okay, so he got a fairly good spot here. Would be a shame if something happens to it. No, so we got agriculture. It's a good question actually, like what do you do after agriculture? That's a good question and
Oh, farmers, pray that your summers be wet and your winters
clear. Not gonna go archery, it's a placeholder, but what do I go for? I mean, let's think about that. Fishing, no. You might think we have a lake here, but I have more than enough commerce. I don't want to go fishing. Really, I want bronze working. But if I do that, my worker won't have anything to do for a fairly long time. Although, I suppose, you know, he can build two farms. He has to move around a little bit. It's gonna take him like 15 turns to do that. And by the time I get both, by the time my worker is even out, and by the time I farm both, I'm pretty sure I might have bronze working in already. The other idea would be, like, you could think, okay, you know, I have floodplains, let's go for pottery. Let's go real pottery and floodplain, but that's gonna really hinder my production a lot. I won't be able to really expand. And Cyrus is imperialistic, he's gonna be pumping out the settlers, even though this spot here is not the best to do that, to use that imperialistic bonus. And usually they build a settler in their second city quite often. So with all that in mind, I don't want to go like cottage and lose time. I have decent commerce, I can go bronze working, let's do that. Quite a bit that I have to chop here. And we are moving one tile at a time. We have a scout. We don't want to let him die. It's very valuable. A very valuable unit. And oh, okay. Oh, Hannibal again. And he knows other people, presumably. Let's watch Hannibal, maybe. Or do I watch Cyrus maybe? Not sure about that. Like, if he's gonna be my enemy, I want to know what he... I might want to know what he's doing. On the other hand, if I take him out, then the spy points will be wasted on him. So that's... Hannibal is more of a long-term threat. Might be worth knowing what he's up to. But really, what's the use of spy points? I mean... I know what he's attacking, but I can't trade with him, and if I could find out like Osiris is getting longbows or whatever, that might be more valuable, you know. Because realistically, if I wanna go for somebody, it's gonna be Osiris. So I think I will keep my points on him. Okay, so we have to take a risk here. Oh, of course he has gold. What a bastard, man. Oh my god. Yeah, but that's a nice... I really... If I have copper, like... But where could I have copper even? I can't have copper in my capital. Maybe. I don't know, man. Could be anywhere. God damn it. Almost got taken out, huh? Let's go here. It's a defensive position. Okay. Yeah, it's a funny... little crater. Okay. I thought we are playing rocky climate, but all these bastards, this bastard has great land, man. Mine is also okay. Oh, barbarian archer here. Let's hope maybe Cyrus might take him out. Okay, so let's improve that first. It has a hammer. It's the same amount of food because it has irrigation and this has no irrigation. Building a warrior, we need units on the field, definitely. One moment. Okay, yeah, so warrior seems fine.
The man who moves a mountain begins by carrying away small stones.
Okay, yeah. I don't have to know what's there, really. I mean, I think I'll go back. And yeah, you have a jungle area here. So I think that's jungle already. Mm-hmm. But this is great land. I mean, like, it's gonna depend on the copper, I think, like where we go. Interestingly, you didn't choose to build a settler here in size 4 already. It'll be interesting to see where he goes once he does build a guy. Will happen sooner or later. So there are panthers, so a bit dangerous to be here. Let's move into the forest maybe. I mean, I'm afraid of like a barbarian archer getting killed, but like moving into a barbarian archer would be bad, but on the other hand, if I'm on flatland, I might get sniped by some wild animal. And that's not great either. I could just wait for the animals to despawn. That might be the play here. There's nothing immediate that I have to find out about my surroundings. It's a good thing I have scouted all of that. So if there's copper here, I will find out. And I wouldn't go much deeper, like there's a jungle here. I have to check out this area, I suppose, but I'm getting a warrior out. Let's just wait a bit. Okay, got the farm, nice, very good. Now we have to go all the way here. There shouldn't be a panther here. That's I don't think there should be. Nah, there shouldn't be one. Okay, so 9 turns, bronze working. He did expand, where did he go? I don't know that, do I? I don't know that. Maybe, yeah, maybe backfilled the place. Yeah. So we are growing to size, might even go size 6 really. Size 6 and Whipper Settler. Yeah, I think that might be the way to go. Oh, barbarians, okay. Nice spot. Might be fish there too. They both went for bronze working early. Hammurabi, okay, there he is. Okay, so where does that leave me then? Yeah, okay, so we can't get that in the near future. So where do you want to go? Again, you want to go to the copper, and I'm really thinking maybe even X-Rush. Maybe I X-Rush him. Can I tell? I think the capital might be on... I'm not sure I can tell that. Doesn't matter though, he is not a very powerful... Not a big unit builder. I can take him out, no doubt about that. If I had to choose right now, like where to go, I would think... Well, the first thing I'm thinking is... First thing I'm thinking, I need to kind of put a guy here. Since even to just Fogbust. This guy is a problem. But we can fight him maybe here. No. Eventually he's gonna come in, but... Can fight him here. Here that's a bit more tricky. Since I do have a corn here, I have to protect. And there might be like copper there. So I do think I will go down here. Next warrior goes up, I think. Also, it's not good to go here. There's an archer here and he wins a fight, he's gonna come in. I can delay the farm by one turn though. Yeah, so okay, there's a jungle here. I wonder if I want to check that. I mean, who knows, it might be copper. Although I have to tell you, I don't think I would go all the way up here just to get copper. But it would be good to know, I suppose. Okay. Yeah, so let's just go back. Okay, so here you have to kill... like one turn. If I'm gonna chop, where would I chop? I think here is a pretty good spot. Why not? Again, there can't be any copper in my area. I'm not sure if I should go here. I think I will go here, just to share the food, really. It also doesn't require me to go animal husbandry. Yeah, so I think X-Rush, it doesn't quite line up. Since I don't have my metal nearby. Unless it's like here, but I doubt that. And in that case, with the rich land that I have, I can easily go here and here. And a free city horse archer rush is very much on the cards. In the cards, on the table, whatever. Okay, can you... Yeah, well... Just have to make sure we get the warrior out. Since this guy will become unhappy. So, okay, so we had one turn of idle time, it's not a big deal. Okay, do we move, or I think we just stay here. And this guy might be good as a Fogbuster. The Fogbusting a huge area here, man. It's like all this area is Fogbusted now. I think it's pretty good. Now let me find out about copper. How about, okay.
It is entirely seemly for a young man killed in battle to lie mangled by
okay,
the bronze
so
spear.
He has
in
copper,
death,
but I don't.
All things appear fair.
The crazy play would be go here and just build axes and take the capital out. I don't think I'm gonna do that. It's too far away, it's gonna cost, I have to build a road all the way. It's actually kind of interesting thought. Yeah, it's an idea to do that. I'm not even sure if I'm gonna be in time though. I mean, they really prioritize copper quite highly. So I'm willing to bet that his next city will will grab that area here. So it's a long shot, and I don't think it's a good play anyway. It's gonna cost me a lot. It's one of the things that, if it was closer, maybe, but here it's not really. I have to say though, it's interesting. It's not good, probably, but it's interesting. And okay, let's chop. I think I'm gonna go real pottery. We are playing no tech trading, so your economy is very important. And starting cottages early is definitely good. Now, we don't have copper. We could go animal husbandry as well, but we can do that after pottery as well. It's not a huge issue, I think. It's one cow at the end of the day, and yeah, I don't. Maybe if it was tech trading, I might do that, since you can catch up later. But this would really put me behind. I don't even think I can get there in time, you know? It's nah. So many things can go wrong if you try that. It's exciting idea. It's an interesting idea, but not good. Probably. Okay, let's try that. It's worth that. Idea here is to get to size 6 to whip a settler. I'm gonna put the chop into a settler. Since I have to, you know, put one turn into it anyway, why not now? Could also do a 2-pop whip. Yeah, but I think I do a 3-pop whip actually. More overflow, more preparation. I think I want to go here first. I think that's more under threat from the evil. Oh shit, why did I do that, huh? Doesn't actually matter because, yeah, it kind of matters. Why did I do that? What's wrong with me, man? It's not that bad though, since we can just do that, but it was not necessary. I lost one beaker, a bit of production. Yeah. Okay, so what now? Essentially we are chopping like a lot. Clear all that land here. Or maybe I can't really improve anything for that guy in the early game. So you might as well chop here, I suppose. Might be continents. Do they like each other actually? Oh, hey. Really? I didn't think that would be like that. Huh, okay. Hammurabi dislikes Cyrus. Good to know. Oh yeah, but I am spiritual, so that's okay. And I think all that overflow is going into our worker. What the hell is that? Okay, by the way, let's move out. And is he gonna kill maybe that archer? Actually, how do I even go there, you know? I mean, how do I not get killed by that guy? I might have to put the overflow into. What if I do that actually? Like, what if I just. I whipped the settler. But what if I just get out warrior first? Wouldn't that be smarter? Since I don't know what. I might need two guys for that. And this way I make sure that by the time my settler gets here, I will have cleaned up. Maybe he died now, but I wouldn't count on it. Think that it might have been the play, yeah. Yeah, what now? Chop here, build a road. After that. Sounds good to me. Yeah, he's alive.
Put your shoulder to the wheel.
Goddamn bastard. See what he does. Two turn worker. Yeah, it's, I like overflow. In these situations, you have lots of food, and I mean, you have to kind of get production. There's no mines or anything like that, but you can get stuff done anyway. After that, maybe another warrior to need a happiness guy here, and I still think that's a good spot because I claim four floodplains actually. And if I don't do that, Cyrus might like go here or whatever, here, and we don't want that. Okay, so he's here now. We have to defend in the city. I am aggressive, so it should be okay, but yeah, it's a bit spicy. It should be fine. Monument? Nah. Barracks maybe. Warrior maybe. But really barracks, I think. Let's prepare the rush. Okay, so this guy is... Wait. That was the point of the whole operation. Take the food. I have two warriors here. If I need another warrior, I could whip him later, but I think just putting hammers into our barracks is more productive. Monument? Nah. I guess it depends, like, do I want a library here? I probably do, since I have a lot of food here. Maybe hire a few scientists. So if I get a library, I don't need a monument, no. No tech trading, so probably you want libraries everywhere, maybe. Not everywhere, but in a city with floodplain cottages, I think you do. So, getting another worker. And... do you want to build roads? Like, is there anything in particular we have to chop now? I think not. Building roads might be a good idea, though. Just connecting that really quickly. And I'm having this chop here. Okay, so do I want another warrior or... Actually, I'm thinking I put this chop into another settler. Think that's better. Or a worker, but... Once this archer is dealt with, I can move my one warrior down here. Actually, though... I could save the chop to decide what I want to do with the hammer. Like if you press 1, you can clear your production bar. Another warrior, like, there might be problems coming down from down here. And maybe more importantly, I will need a guy here to not become unhappy. So with that in mind, I think I save the hammers and next turn finish the warrior with that chop. This way I don't pay more unit cost earlier than I have to. lose one hammer, but that's okay. I don't have much production here anyway. And the settler can just be whipped again. I don't have to chop into it. There's no need to do that, really. Rolling floodplains, but this thing is not even connected to the river, so I kind of have to do that, or I can do it here. Yeah, I could build two roads here and here, and actually maybe I like it a bit more, you know, since the roads here actually make sense, since I want to chop these tiles later. Roading the floodplains on the other hand is like, what's the point? I mean, yeah, before the war begins, I would road here to get a quicker reinforcement, you know, quicker way to reinforce things, but it's not like now, it's not really important. Roading here and here makes a bit more sense to me. It takes three turns either way, but this way I can chop these tiles later. So this seems pretty intuitive to me. Let's do that. Here I'm defending. Getting ready for pottery. Did he die, or is he returning to the... He's returning to this... Okay, he killed... Okay, so he's wounded. I should be fine. Famous last words, but I should be fine. Mine here, I don't... What's the point of a mine here, I wonder? Would I really work it? Maybe. Yeah, maybe I would work it, actually. Since there is so much food. Just to control the growth a little bit. And it's a river. Riverside mine. Yeah, but I kind of doubt. Don't think it's the best use of my time. Holy crap, man. Okay, that's Judaism. Okay. So is he going for Cyrus or what? This guy won't kill me, that's okay. We are getting another warrior out. We have to control it a little bit here. We want to go here. Or here, no, I think here. It claims more. We might actually even go, you know, cocky on the sugar. Or like here, actually. You know why? Because that's gonna go into my culture borders anyway, you know, in 8 turns. And this way, maybe, might even be like horses here. And I just grab the whole river. And... I kind of want, like later, I kind of want to have the option to put a thing here as well though. So maybe going on the sugar might be the play. I think I like it actually, I think I like that idea. Need to think about that a bit. Let's do that a little. Okay. Oh, and more barbarians. Man. That's a lake. Okay. So now we are fog busting that. I really would hate for a guy to spawn here. It would really kill me. It wouldn't kill me, but you know. Wouldn't be the best thing ever. Okay. He is going for. Okay, that's very good. The warrior went away. Hey, they like me. They don't want to hurt me. That's good. So, we can actually use these guys. One guy at least. And if he ever comes back, I can put one turn into a warrior, so I can like whip him really cheap. On the cheap. So we got the road, we will be... Persia is plotting, guys. That's bad. Okay, after pottery we go straight for archery. I could go archery right now, but I really need cottages, man. Like, what else do I do? And I hope I get archers in time. Like, shouldn't attack me in the next... I mean, he's plotting, right? I mean, he just got copper. Maybe immortals and... Oh, immortals, shit. He has immortals and I have archers. Oh my god. Maybe he doesn't have immortals, right? Maybe he only has copper. Okay, crap. That's, sure. It's not good. Let's shop the border area so he doesn't like put a guy here and just choke me to death. Man. Why would he do that, huh? What's wrong with that guy? A bastard, man. And here, essentially, I want to be prepared to build cottages, like here, maybe. So now we are just pre-chopping pretty much, I think. We want granaries as well. I might chop the barracks actually, I'm not sure. Let's pre-chop though, nothing wrong with that. Here we are trying to whip another guy. And the plan is to go on the sugar for now. It will delay animal husbandry, but I have to go archery. It's definitely have to do that, man. There's no choice here. See, now I get like 14 beakers. If I do that, I get 13. 13. It gets rounded down. So here I get 14. That's better. Save a beaker. Okay, so do we put this shop into something or not? We can put the shop into a settler. There's definitely nothing wrong with that. And here, for now, I have nothing to really. Yeah, I'm gonna be chopping archers in a moment, but that's a different thing. We are not aware yet. Archery, definitely.
Hath not the potter power over the clay to make one vessel unto honor and another unto dishonor?
So, granary, yeah, well. We can whip it a size 4, pretty much. And here we don't need one, I think, for now. I mean, we don't need them for now, period, but if you're gonna whip something, then why not that? And let's just get cottages so we can tech a little bit quicker. attack me, you bastard. Not yet. Is he really gonna come in here? Yeah, he might go come in here, but he won't win, right? I'm fully fortified. I kind of don't want to move out, is the thing. You know, I don't want to move out. It would make me unhappy if I move out. But losing that city would make me even unhappier. God damn it. I don't want to whip a freaking warrior here. That's the last thing I want to do. Okay. Maybe I can still grow in... Let's do that actually, just for one turn. I hate to do it, but... Archery in four turns. Yeah, he doesn't really want to hurt me, apparently. Still though, it's probably better if I have two guys here at all times. Okay, you take that back. And maybe one more cottage and when we freaking start chopping. Maybe even now actually. Yeah, maybe just forget the cottages for now. I need to be ready with the archers. Right? I think I do, I mean... Maybe another cottage, though... Like, if I just wait a moment, I could take a peek, right? At the build-up. And then make up my mind. If there's nothing here, I have a bit of time, I mean... I really want my economy to... be in good shape for the long term. Holy crap! Okay, first thing, he is freaking trying to take my land. That's the first thing that comes to mind when I see that. The second thing is, holy crap, that's a build up. Shit. Yeah, but two X-Men, one Spearman, it's not the end of the world. It's gonna throw some archers at me maybe, but that's okay. But this cottage will get pillaged anyway, I think. You know, like, where does he want to go? I can't help but feel that he's gonna go like here maybe. Maybe he sees something I don't see, maybe there are like horses here and he wants to grab all four. So what that tells me is that... I'm gonna be late, right? Just thought, like, if I build a road here, but that won't matter. If I build a road here, I can go here, but I can't settle for one more turn. Shit. I still want... Like, depending on what he does, I can still get a city here, but it's messed up, man. It's already messed up big time. Need monarchy, man. I need monarchy big time. Imagine if I had monarchy. It's cottage everything. At first I have to survive here. He's like, how do I make peace even? Maybe I should have gone for the copper. Yeah, but it's okay, so first thing I have to get archers out. It's definitely the first thing I have to do probably. And finishing the cottage seems pretty suicidal. So let's chop. Maybe wars would be good. Yeah, maybe. But archers first, of course, and then we have to think about it. We have one cottage. It's better than nothing. I'd like to have more, but he doesn't allow me to do that. And he's going for me like 99%. Not much you can do. And he's... Oh, I hate that. Maybe he'll turn around after my border pop, but probably not. Yeah. Like, my only chance is that he tries to go. Like, look at that. There's the circle here, right? So, if he does use the circle to make his decision, then he might move another turn. Now, if he goes here, my game is not ruined, but I would really, really... Are you kidding me, man? Is that a... What the hell? Are you going in with that? Or did you just kill the guy? And where did the other guys go? He's a huge army here. Where did they go? So many questions. So little answers. God damn it. Okay, don't do it to me, man. Don't do it to me. Oh, God. Don't do it, man. You know you don't want to do it. Just don't do it. I might have to cold whip an archer here. If he moves here, I'm whipping an archer. Hell, I'm... Yeah, let's... Do I save... Do I actually save a hell? You know what? Do I save for overflow to make an archer? In one turn? I don't think I do. No, I think I get the barracks. Yeah. Need promotions, man. He has X-Men. And I have flatland cities. That's bad. Don't... Okay, good.
Do not throw the arrow. Oof.
Good. Not ideal. But... Not game ending, at least. He moved back. He is building up, I think. Okay, so where do I go? Well, here or here. He messed up. Nobody can use that tile now. Thanks to him. I wanted to go here. And on the sugar. Which, in my mind, is a superior spot. Like, it has a free food... You know, you have the cow, free food, you claim all that crap here. But obviously he won't allow me to do that. And if I go here, he might... Like if I do here, I'm blocking him off, right? If I go here, he might go here. So really, I have only one choice to make. And here you go. Thank you, you bastard. I didn't want it to be like that, but he forced me into this direction. I hope he is happy, because I am not. Man. Yeah, I think so, man. I think you do that when barracks and then archers. Just hope I have enough in time. It's very early, man. It didn't leave me much time. I need guys. We probably had a guy down here as well. If he declares on me like now, it's over. I hope he won't. Oh, I didn't. I hit end turn. I didn't mean to. But I think it was okay, right? I was finished. I think. It's a bit anticlimactic. I didn't mean to do that. But I think it's fine. So I'm back. Okay. Archers, yeah, definitely archers. Here. Actually, that's too much. Shit. Gonna lose a bit of hammers here, but that's okay. It's not great, but that's okay. This guy is on standby here. Yeah, if he declared last turn, it would have been over, but he didn't. It's very early, man. It's my, like, I'm playing Monty, but it feels like I'm playing against Monty. You know what I mean? I mean, look at this. Fortunately, it's not that game end. I don't see any immortals, so that's good. Because immortals, in case you forgot, would freaking eat my archers. Oh, God. How do I get out of this crap here? How do I get out of this? And do I go masonry or animal husbandry? Kind of need masonry, right? I put one turn into animal husbandry, but was not good. Oh God. Okay, so we have to get a number of like 4 archers maybe. And we really need masonry. We also need cottages, we need everything. And I can tell you though that for now we won't be expanding. There is no particularly great spot that I would need to claim. My idea is still a horse archer rush, kind of, but it's a little bit, like, I could have gotten 4 cities, like here and here would have been really nice, very close to the capital, very productive, but he ruined that, didn't he? He just took a big crap on that idea. And now I don't really have a great 4th spot, maybe here? No. So, yeah, it is what it is, you know? We have to work with what we have to work. So really, I'm thinking I need masonry to get walls, because it will make a big difference, man, if he attacks me. And then animal husbandry. Hope we have horses. I mean, you can still go here. It's a bit ugly, but hey. You can work food, you can work nice cottages. It's, I think I might do that. But more importantly, let's get out our archers. Yeah, let's really, I will feel better once I have, like, holy shit, he is coming. I have no walls, I'm not ready. Need to do that. I can tell you why we need to do that, because we have, if we get out on a guy now, he will get time to fortify. It's 1 axeman, 2 spearmen. That's the dangerous thing. The spearmen, actually, my warrior can kind of defend against that, like 50-50 maybe. I will have 2 warriors and 2, maybe 3 archers. and I might have to whip an archer. It's not great, I hate to do it, but it's bad, but hey, what can you do? I mean, god damn it, it's gonna depend. Like, if at X-Men, like, if he is combat 1 and City Raider 1, he's gonna eat my archer. Probably. So we need a bit of luck. We have to chop, actually. We have to chop like a freaking bastard. Didn't he pre-chop some crap here? Did I imagine that? I can get another archer in, actually. That's very important. I can get another archer. Get the blessed archer in the blessed city of Teotihuacan or whatever, and three archers sounds a bit better, you have to admit. It still sounds a bit dodgy. Actually, how am I ever gonna make peace? I have to gift him a city, actually. I have to gift him, I have to put a city here, and once he is willing to talk, we gift him that, and so then the question is, do I declare on him? Like, it sounds a bit crazy, but if I declare war on him, he will talk earlier than if he, but that would give me -3. It would also give me -1. Nah, let's not do that. -3 is really bad. He's never gonna like me. And my idea is like to get him to pleased. Although actually I'm gonna attack him anyway, right? So maybe I should declare on him now. Just to get him to the table a bit earlier. -1 with Hannibal is not good, but it's negligible really. And it's not that important. And there is no way we are gonna... This here is not a long-term thing, it's gonna escalate anyway. So the play might be to declare on him. On the other hand, if I do it now, he might move with X-Men here. I'm gonna lose the city here. If I don't declare, he might take another turn of moving. But he can declare next turn, maybe. That might be the thing to do. Do we road here? I mean, I think you have to chop, right? That's the only thing. Also, let me do that really quickly. Yeah, I think you have to chop. We can get another archer out. God damn it, dude. Why does it have to be like that? I don't know. Yeah. So my idea here is to do a little bit of that. Yeah. Okay, so we have, okay, so he is, oh no, wait, where is he going with that, huh? Not sure. Okay, we have two archers, with promotions. We will have four archers, actually. We can whip this guy. And we will whip this guy, since he's kind of forcing me to do that. And what do I do here, though? I mean, he's coming at me. We have to move back with that. Oh, man. Whipping archers here like an idiot. Unbelievable. You know, I hate to say it, but the play here might be to build a road here, so I can, like, get here in time. So do that for one turn. Thank God I built the roads like that, and not like that. Masonry, it's almost a bit late for that, huh? My economy is shit. Because I'm paying like 5 gold per turn. Okay, so now the moment would be to declare on him. Like, because he's gonna declare anyway. I think I do it. I think you do it. He's gonna be a -3. Which will actually put him at annoyed after the war. Like, once he makes peace, he's gonna be annoyed. Instead of cautious. And yes, I want to go for him, but if he is annoyed, he might start plotting again really early. And before I attack him, really, I think at this point you wait for construction. You go monarchy first with this kind of situation. So having him annoyed with me is not something I want. Yes, he would talk earlier if I declare on him, but is that really like the most important thing? And it might not be the most important thing. Let's just write it out. I think, yeah. I don't like it, but bastard. And this way he got the -1, yeah, for whatever that's worth, which is not much. But hey. Keep on my lower. Plant at the Gillies. Plant at the Gillies. Monawati, Chia, Monawati. This will also connect my city, so that's not too bad. Next turn we'll put archers. We have 2 archers here and 2 warriors. Against X-Men and, oh man. X-Men and Spearmen. It's not great, but or I could do it. I could put the archer here. And in. This might be the big brain play here, actually. This might be like the big solution to all my problems. Unless he wins, of course. But my odds here should be better. So if I do that, combat promotion. I don't like combat promotion, but. I don't think he will attack, actually. It's like, do it here, like, you know, and force him to go here when I move back. And he has to attack across a river, so, yeah. But if he attacks my archer, yeah, he might attack my archer, man. He might. Let's go combat. Just in case. And here we have a situation. X-Men, 2 spearmen. The spearmen are not that dangerous. I have, what, I have 2 archers. I don't even have to whip that, actually. I don't think I do. Oh yeah, maybe I do. Yeah, maybe I do. Plant at Achilles. Masonry would also be really good. I have to get the fortification bonus. Quite simply. And this is the main point of attack here. Let's see how it goes, man. I hope I'm not unlucky. I really hope I'm not unlucky. What about this archer? I think you just... I can't keep whipping. That's the point. I can't keep whipping archers. I have to, like, chop them out. And not get too unlucky. That being said, maybe you just pull the trigger here, man. Maybe you do that. Make sure you stay alive and Oh man. Like realistically, that X-Men will win probably when I have two wounded archers. And then, yeah, maybe I have to do that actually. Damn it. Bullshit. So what? His archer killed my archer. Or what? Yeah. What? Yeah, okay. 20%? 20%? And you win that? Okay. Yeah, I don't know, man. This might be. This might be bad. Tja. We have to chop. Put my scout in there, maybe even. Why not? Ouch. He's moving back. He, okay, I did fend him off here. That's good. The spearman will just sit here now. Not do pyramids is really early build. Not sure who built that. Looks like a continents map. Maybe, like, these warriors don't do anything. I should probably delete them. Save me some gold. The scout is not. Like, in this situation, he's not actually helping. At all. And I have to get my economy back on track, you know? Like, I have to trim the fat a little bit. The scout is good though for scouting later. Find out what's going on the map and all that, but at the moment it's pretty rough. After these two chops, I really have to get cottages up. He is turning around, thank God. Here, two archers, keep them here. Here we have one archer here, man. It's one archer. But he is also seems to be struggling to keep up the attack. So we will have like three archers here and hopefully walls in the near future. So that's not too bad. I would like to finish this archer on this turn if I could. Just to get him here earlier for fortification. And actually, I don't think I need two archers here. I will move him out. Have to let my cities grow a little bit now. it's really important. You got a water pop, great. But he is moving away for now. I am getting like I need walls here, man. It's gonna make a big difference. He won't talk, like he killed a few guys, he won't talk, he's gonna come back with maybe 5 X-Men. I really have to get 50% defense in here. So I stand a chance. That's good. Again, let's get the archer out. Just so I have the numbers, it can fortify. And yeah, maybe connect that to get some health. Why did he have to do that, man? I don't know. I told you he can be fairly aggressive. Another archer coming, not sure what that means, but shouldn't be too important. And yeah, look at that, he's gonna come in again in a moment with all that crap. We really have to get, like, somehow we have to squeeze out a bit of commerce, a bit more commerce. Can we get there in 2 turns somehow? No, that's not possible. Shit. Okay, we have to cottage. I'm not sure what that archer is doing, but we have to cottage. Even here, it's a bit safer than the floodplains. So I have a good, like a good army, really. I kind of like it. My numbers are looking good. We survived for now, but god damn it. Okay, where is he going? He's not going yet. He's healing, waiting for reinforcements. Gives me time to get that crucial, very crucial. Walls, to build the walls, really important. 5 archers, that's... This scout can maybe go here. Okay, so what's going on here? I think we just grow here. Just grow, don't do anything fancy. Maybe we can... Thank god he has no immortals. What's going on here? That's okay. Seems fine to me. He's not moving in. I also have to get a settler here, right? Oh man. Whipper settler, prepare to make peace. And that's where the scout might come into, might come in handy. Find out where I can move a settler. So that's good thing I didn't delete him, I guess. Yeah. So let's like... we have to kind of take care of the economy a little bit now. Like... do I dare to cottage that? I think I might dare to do that. 5 archers. 5 archers behind the walls. It's not too bad. He's coming.
It is from their foes, not their friends, that cities learn the lesson of building high walls.
No immortals, good. No, don't do that. Here you go. Animal husbandry, writing, I think. It's a play here. Yeah, sure, man. He took that, what? Oh, uh-oh. Yeah, look at the whip anger, man. It's bad. Can I trade? Can't do anything. If Hammurabi could give me the religion, that would be really good. The wars will. Oh, forgot to promote almost. Holy shit. Like, the war should come in before the attack, right? Yeah, they did. And he didn't attack. He knows he can't do anything. Okay, I don't have to do that like that. Let's just grow into unhappiness. Wonders are going quite quickly. So I can't really cottage anything. That's okay, though. Trying to get to size 6 to actually we have to actually grow the capital a little bit quicker. Although I don't think he will talk for another maybe 10 turns even. If he does lose that army though, that might change his mind a little bit. So do I really maybe do that, huh? In that case? Maybe just work maximum food. I think you do that, yep. I think you might want to do that. Ouch. Bastard. Okay, so we are getting a fresh archer. So I lost one battle, right? Yep. I won't talk yet. For the general, good job, buddy. There's an archer coming here. Why is there an archer coming here? What the hell? What does that mean? Well, it means I'm in trouble, I guess. Yeah, I can't believe I have to do that, but maybe I do. Since I don't, or I could move an archer back, but that seems pretty foolish. Like a foolish thing to do, maybe. I could move a warrior back. That wouldn't really hurt me all that much. Move a warrior back. So at least he can't take my capital with that archer. He's gonna pillage, oh man. Pillage, won't he? Yeah, I think you will. What the hell? That guy won another battle? Okay, let's kill that guy. We can kill him now. And he should, I mean. Mm, Great, now we have a guy next to my capital like that. That's wonderful. Absolutely great. Trying to get to animal husbandry. Maybe we can do that in 2 turns. Maybe, maybe. If one of these cottages grows, then I don't think it will. But actually, yeah, we can if you just like. That's a bit crazy, maybe. But do I even need animal husbandry? I mean, getting chariots would be good against the X-Men. But let's check that next turn again, maybe. Yeah, it's, I don't think it's that important. I think the food is more important. Maybe if I do it for one turn, you can maybe justify that, though. Maybe. Maybe. But maybe not. I have to grow. I one turn. Okay. And do that. So we turned around, I think we kind of, for now we are fine, but without a vase, I think it would have been over. Okay, so let's get ready for that. And of course I have no horses or anything. What's wrong with my maps recently? Why do I have to suffer like that, hmm? Why? Why, oh why? Can you do that? You can. Four archers, it's not that great. I'm hoping to make peace though before he attacks me again. Here we whip a granary into barracks probably. And yeah. And here a library I think would be good. Long term. He wants to negotiate, but he wants a city, so we have to gift him one. Wonderful. But now that Archer moves back, so that's good, I suppose. We have a bit of time though before he attacks me again. Build a road here maybe, so that guy can go straight here, then here, and. Yeah, of course, yes, of course. Freaking hell. My scout is gonna die. Oh wait, I can. Need a guy to escort my settler. Maybe I can go like here. There's a road here. It's a bit dangerous. Maybe here, here. I would have to defend him, but it can be done. I think. What happened? Really? Okay.
Monawatil. Monawatil. Monawatil.
Well, we got rid of him, but at what cost? Actually, my scout didn't get killed. Go figure. He still wants a city, okay. But Archer can't kill my Archer, there's no way. And I really have to make peace before he comes in again, because I'm not really ready. Three archers. It's not exactly the gold standard in defending. And are you kidding me? Are you really kidding me now? What the hell? Okay, I have to kill that guy. Don't have to kill that guy, but I kind of want to. He is blocking my path. I can gift it like right on his borders, which I don't, yeah, maybe here. It has to be safe, yeah, because if I go deeper he might snipe my guy, and I have to get out of this war, man. It's really important I do that. Do that here, you can. Can you not just work a cottage? Would that be possible? And now we can cottage these tiles, which is good. He has catapults, what a joke. What, yeah, with his gold mine, yeah, no shock there. Carthage has nine cities, oh my god. It's not going great, that's for sure. I don't see any immortal, but what I will do is I will just go here, stay here, and plop that down next turn. Okay, yeah, he would end me with that. He would definitely kill me. Since I have no metal, I can't really defend myself. Or maybe I could, but it would really ruin my game, is the point. So yeah. And I will put a city here just to share cottages. It's all I can do at this point. Library here, and maybe this spot here could rip a settler and here library, something like that. Not sure. Yeah, okay, just in time. He won't make peace, right? Yeah. He will take the city, though. Texcoco. Thank God. He has 3 gold. He has 3, not 1 gold. 3 gold. Okay. Good to know. Good to know. Let's go scouting. Monawatil. Unbelievable. Yeah, well, I survived, but really behind now. Three cities, I can get a fourth. I have no horses. How do I do this actually? I have jaguars, that's great. It's not really great, but the thing is, he has three gold mines, which means he's gonna get like engineering and all that really early. It's really a disaster. Don't really see how I take him out. Oh, and look, he found iron here. Thanks to my gift, he has iron now. Wonderful. And I probably don't have iron, if I had to guess. No. I mean, last game I had elephants at least, that was good. Without elephants against engineering. But if I could even take like two cities, that would already be really good. So I think I'm gonna go for that construction idea, but also I think that I have to develop a little bit and get monarchy before I go for construction. Let's play a peaceful game, put another city down here. It has no fresh water, but I have enough health and should be fine. Maybe even, nah, I think four cities. You can play with four cities. And yeah, it's not great though. I mean, if these guys get 15, then I don't know. But okay, I will take a break for now. Thank you for watching and I'll be back.